Let's talk about the relationship between ketones on your mood, not just depression, but anger, irritability, anxiety. So many people who start the ketogenic diet in periodic prolonged fasting experience a huge improvement in their mental health. It really brings their mood up from these lower emotions to a much greater emotion. Now, I want to differentiate two things. One is your mood being affected by situations and maybe a mental problem. If you get in an argument with someone and you're angry, okay, that's a direct cause and effect relationship. But what about in the situation where you're just depressed, you're irritable, you're angry without that situation? What is up with that? And it'd be really interesting to find out the true percentage of people who are depressed, angry, irritable, and have anxiety, and how much of that is related to just their fuel for their brain and their overall brain chemistry. Especially because when you observe people going on low carb and fasting, there is a direct and immediate improvement in mood. Now, there's been 15 studies showing the relationship between the ketogenic diet and mood, and the results were kind of mixed. The results show there may be improvements in your mental status, okay? But if you look at these studies, some studies were just observational, which use questionnaires, which they're not very credible. A lot of other studies were done in mice, and how are you going to show results with emotion on mice? And also, if you dig into the studies, you're going to find out that a lot of these studies weren't even using the ketogenic diet. They weren't low carb. And also, a human would never consume the diet that these mice were on. So I don't know how valid those studies would be. And then yet other studies were just using ketones, exogenous ketones, not changing the diet. And so these studies don't really reflect the actual healthy version of the ketogenic diet that I would recommend for someone. And also, they're not including fasting, because the way you get into ketosis is a low carb diet or fasting or a combination of both. But the benefits on your emotional state is not just ketones. But when you're doing fasting, there's a lot of other things that can occur with additional brain chemicals being increased, like brain-derived neurotrophic factor, which I'm going to do a video on. But here's what we know. There's a condition called brain insulin resistance, where the brain is not getting enough insulin, and so we have a decreased insulin sensitivity. And there's definitely a direct effect on having that condition and being depressed or having a lowered mood. We also know that diabetics are three times more likely to get depression. We also know that metformin, which directly addresses insulin resistance, has been shown to decrease depression. Nasal insulin sprays, when you spray insulin right up into the sinuses and it can go directly into the brain, has been shown to decrease depression as well. So when you fix this insulin resistance thing, you definitely improve the mood. We also know that when you do fasting, you have an increased absorption of tryptophan, which is a precursor to serotonin, which is like the happy hormone that actually makes you happier. So there's all this additional data that supports doing the ketogenic diet and fasting to increase your mood. So my question is this: what happens when you diagnose someone with the wrong problem? What are the consequences of that? If a person has a physically caused depression coming from their diet, and you diagnose them with some mental illness or mental disease, and worse yet, treat them with a drug that has side effects, what are the consequences of that? I mean, you could really mess someone up if you give them the wrong diagnosis, telling them your problem is this, when in actuality it's this thing completely over here. And so, if you are new to my channel and you have some lowered emotional state and you haven't tried the ketogenic diet yet or fasting, I challenge you to try it out because I think you're going to notice a huge shift in how you feel. Now, I recently interviewed a guy, a fascinating success story, which I'm going to put the link down below. If you haven't seen this, you have to watch this. Here's a man that had seriously high blood sugars. I'm talking in the 700s, okay? He was going into a coma. He was rushed to the hospital. He was overweight, depressed, on a medication. And so he decided to do himself in and stop eating for 4 days. And it backfired. He started feeling better. He started feeling happier, which is fascinating. So he accidentally did fasting and found out surprisingly that his depression went away when he started doing fasting. He stumbled on one of my videos. He started the ketogenic diet. He started doing fasting. And you have to watch his success story because he pulled himself completely right out of that deep, dark state of depression. And now, not only has he lost weight and had health benefits, but he's happy. He no longer has depression. His willpower is excellent. So, number one, you have the relationship between brain insulin resistance and your mood. You also have something called the HPA axis, okay? Hypothalamus, pituitary, adrenal pathway. What happens if that pathway is altered and you have higher amounts of cortisol? You're gonna have anxiety. So, the ketogenic diet and doing fasting can improve that situation as well. And then you have the direct effect on dopamine, which is like the pleasure hormone. And the more sugar someone has and the more carbohydrates, the more problem they're going to have with dopamine and the more dopamine resistance they're going to have. And you're not going to be able to experience pleasure if you have a problem with dopamine. So that would equate to depression and apathy. And then you have the direct effect on serotonin. If you're on a high-carb diet, that's going to directly inhibit the ability to express serotonin. And when you do fasting, you increase the absorption of tryptophan, which is the precursor to serotonin. You increase the absorption of serotonin and you become happier. And lastly, you have the effect on the hippocampus. It's a known fact that diabetics have atrophy of the hippocampus. And that's the structure in the brain that affects memory, learning. And when you have atrophy of this part of the brain, people get depressed. So, in conclusion, I challenge you to try this diet and fasting at the same time to see if it can actually pull you out of some of these lower emotions to a much higher emotional state. Click down below for more information on how to do that. Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.